这种果实叫白果。李时珍在《本草纲目》当中记载，白果熟食温肺益气，具有健胃补脾、降脂降压、防癌抗癌等作用。那么这种极具食用药用价值的果实是从何而来的呢？在自然条件下，生长缓慢的银杏从栽种到结果要20多年，40年之后才能大量结果，因此白果又被称为公孙果，取公众而孙得食之意。在这个初冬时节，成都人尽情享受着这一片片金黄的美景。
前面就是全部都是山路，大家小心点啊，注意安全喽！
大家加油啊！
大家看到
李静是四川电影电视学院的一名美术老师，和往年一样，每到银杏变黄的季节，李静都会带着他的学生们到成都周边的银杏观赏地写生。
同学们，看到右边这棵巨大的银杏树，你看它的根系都是非常发达。这一棵银杏树就是白岩寺最著名的九子连根银杏树，你看它是一个根。
白岩寺的九子银杏已有上千年的历史，表面上看起来好像是九棵树，实际上九株同根是一株老树被雷击劈死，从树根处萌发出的九棵新树。千年过后，九子环抱，古木参天，这也是今天李静与学生的写生对象。
那么今天出来呀，我们就跟大自然结合。银杏树生长在大自然环境之下，是个什么样的状态？这个角度看过去，好，你就可以天空有了，山也有了，这个树也有了。选景之前这样框一下啊，框到你的画面，横构图、竖构图这样框一下。
银杏是世界上最古老的植物，最早出现在3.45亿年前的石炭纪，与恐龙生活在同一时代，是在过去2亿年依旧保持不变的最古老的树种。如同成都人的乐观闲适，在李静和他学生们的画笔下，呈现出了银杏的坚韧和优雅。
还有一个这个银杏树干，是不是太直了点啊？这个银杏树干，它肯定没有那么笔直嘛。看了一下大家画的效果还不错啊，应该都有收获，都有没有收获？
有。
我们现在下山享用我们的白果炖鸡。
沿着山间小路，穿过银杏拱廊，一桌美味佳肴正在等待着他们。
白果炖鸡，先汆一下水，加点大葱，加点姜片。等它开起了之后，我们就可以滤水了。滤完水，我们就进砂锅，在土砂锅里面煨起。
宋浩是李静的朋友，他在白岩山山腰有个农家小院，今天他特意为他远道而来的朋友们准备了一道成都冬日的特色美食——白果炖鸡。
对，烧过菜之后就把火腿煨在下面。
对，
煨一晚上，早上起来它就熟了。
此时静候在一旁的白果也将在李静宋浩的手中褪去它的外壳，为美味变身。
这里面白果里面是有个星星挑出来，不挑出来的话它影响口感，只有苦味，都是就地取材，山上的上千年的银杏树结的银杏果，然后加姜片和葱，任何东西都不加，原汁原味，非常鲜美又有营养。
经过4-5个小时的小火慢炖，袅袅炊烟中美味正在慢慢酝酿。
白果炖鸡来了，白果炖鸡来，这个菜上了你们就可以开动了。
鲜嫩软糯的白果调和了鸡汤的油腻，鲜美的汤汁在唇齿舌畔间弥留，回味无穷。
为我们成功的银杏先生干杯！
干杯！
我们要去都江堰拍这个银杏，就不知道1424的一个超广这个镜头。
今年57岁的肖建华拍摄银杏已经有7年了。又到银杏洒金时，他开始在全城追寻银杏的身影。今年拍银杏的第一站，肖建华和一群志同道合的朋友决定去到都江堰的灵岩寺。都江堰灵岩寺海拔1700多米，尽管是初冬，但灵岩山上的气温已经跌至10摄氏度以下。
这个位置也不行啊，打了一场霜之后没有阳光的话，它很快这个树叶就掉了，所以我们今天还是带着遗憾来的。
我们就收拾行装下去了哈。
失望之余，肖建华和朋友们并没有气馁，他决心第二天再寻找。
孤银杏在哪边嘛？在那边很多的，要打光圈哈，光圈要打一点。
成都杜甫草堂藏经楼后的这两株银杏，树龄都在1000年以上。高大挺拔的树干衬以草堂的青瓦白墙，彰显着杜甫草堂厚重的历史文化底蕴。在这里，肖建华终于拍到了称心如意的银杏美照。
因为这个草堂的银杏和其他的银杏不一样，一个是公的银杏树，一个是母的银杏树，其他地方没有这种专门去拍的这个两棵对称的排列的这个银杏树。
早在1983年，银杏就被定为成都的市树。在成都的9278株古树名木中，银杏就有1874株。如果要说成都市区里的赏银杏圣地，不得不提成都电子科技大学，这里散落着1600多株大大小小的银杏树。在这个初冬的夜晚，一场关于银杏的诗歌盛宴正在这里上演。
晓看红湿处，花重锦官城。
银杏树下，一首首展现天府文化内涵的诗词名句，在唯美震撼的交响乐中娓娓诵读，串联起了成都与银杏的悠久情缘。
那在成都大学当中呢，你看到的是一种银杏树这个洒满校园的这个大地的时候，银杏独特的这样一个符号和这个城市能够连接的，这是成都所独有的。
成都和安逸这两个字紧紧地联系在一起吧，那种很恬静的氛围，也是我喜欢的。
在这个初冬时节，市区的百花潭公园、锦绣巷、文殊院等地，城市周边的崇州演化池、青城山天师洞、彭州葛仙山等都是赏银杏的圣地。这一片片的金黄成为了成都这个季节独有的美景。2000年前，在西汉大慈父家成都人司马相如笔下，银杏是上千仞达连抱，夸条直唱十叶俊茂。如今这样的景象依旧遍布成都，装点着城市的大街小巷。一叶一菩提，银杏这种世界上最古老的植物，亲历了成都的辉煌过往，见证着成都蓬勃发展的现在。这抹金黄传承着天府文化内涵， 将始终陪伴着成都人的记忆，并将世代延续。
Hello， 要一杯冰美式，少冰，谢谢。
We've always been seeking for some true quality in ourselves. Stay in a quiet space, relieve ourselves, calm down, and read a book. There's no need for a long trip, nor a thick book. As long as I get immersed in the reading, my feeling will tell everything. Stepping upon the spiral staircase.I encountered with this gorgeous bookstore.
This is the new city bookshop in the east of Chengdu. It was originated from Chongqing, and due to the Chengdu-Chongqing economic circle, it has brought a lot of business and culture exchanges to both cities. In my personal perspective, I think any successful commercial design here in Chengdu has reflected the local characteristics of Chengdu and also this inclusiveness. For example, this bookshop, it has the downstairs area, indoors and outdoors, where you could enjoy coffee while reading a book. While you're walking up to second floor, there's this bookshop, and you can access a lot of books.
What is a bookstore supposed to be like? For me, it's not only a commercial place for people to read and buy books, but more importantly, a space of refuge for our emotions and wandering souls. A venue for contemporary life where books and people encounter each other by chance. Does a book have its lifespan? As the way it's designed, lifespan of industrial paper is 100 years. In fact,The paper will become crisp and easily broken after 70 years. However, the book itself, as long as someone continues to read, will be everlasting.
So, we beat on, boats against the current, borne back ceaselessly into the past.
You will find much more possibilities for reading in Chengdu. In a city covered by over 3,000 bookstores, there are many study rooms hidden in the bustling city. Without any guide, I will never independently find the beauty hidden behind dozens of staircases at the end of the elevator.
This one here, the owner used to be a professor of philosophy, and now she had opened this bookshop. And mainly this has collected a lot of philosophy books that you couldn't find usually outside, only here.
Philosophy, religion, aesthetics, and art consist of the gene of this study room. With 24 seats,Open 24 hours a day, no dealings being seen, this place is a heaven for pure reading. The two characters Da Di come from knowledge rambling in the north by Zhuangzi. Heaven and earth proceed in the most admirable way, but they say nothing about them. The four seasons observe the clearest laws.But they do not discuss them. All things have their complete and distinctive constitutions, but they say nothing about them. Da Di is an all-encompassing carrier, just like Chengdu as a carrier of all kinds of goods.
This bookshop is different than all the other retail bookshops. In here, it creates such a quiet space where people can really focus on their own things here. People come to work.And then students bring their homework here. And I feel like you could probably only hear that 5 decibel when you flip the page here. There's a yard in here. There's a garden hidden upstairs. Hello. In Chengdu, those who love reading can always easily start a conversation. Reading a book is exactly like reading a soul, because you get to prune your mind by putting yourselves in others' shoes.
但它里边的游客就不会说是为了打卡过来，然后打卡就走，都是在这边自习，所以觉得就主要就是那个氛围就比较安静，比较适合学习。
子曰：“不知命，无以为君子也；不知礼，无以立也；不知言，无以知人也。”
Admit it, reading is never an easy action, because focusing is what you need. Reading requires thinking, while there are so many temptations in real world, where most people can't hear their thoughts in the hustle and bustle. But you are still reading, even if it's one word, one sentence, one page, or one book, because you are no longer limited between the lines. You can see more of the world.For the universe is way beyond your imagination, and you get to choose your sense of sensibility. When you read, you're not at the corner of a street, nor in your car, nor in your company. You are experiencing the writer's life, and finally you will find yourself through it. Read in Chengdu.
성격은좋은편인것같아요사실은특색이없다고봐야되는데그냥뭐즐기면서네편안하게하는스타일인것같습니다
要一杯澳白吗
澳白我们可以选择烘焙度您平时喜欢喝中度 OK 好的谢谢
换过来拿
好我给你拿过去中度烘焙的澳白
중국어표준말하는추후진이자기소개를하지않으면외국인인줄상상도못합니다청도에서개인커피숍이많아지면서추후진도점점오개내에서화제가되어있습니다왜냐하면추후진의커피공장면접은3000제곱미터비이루기때문입니다
사실조선업계가꾸준히일하면나중에되면대우도좋고생활하는것도크게불편한건없는데근데커피혹은카페이런걸하고싶었어요계속네이거를꽤오랜시간동안고민을했어요아주어렸을때부터제가어렸을때이제부모님이중국에오신거는이제92년도이제수교가되고바로들어오셨고그래서초등학교5학년때부터고등학교졸업할때까지중국에서이제중국인학교를다니면서예언어는빠르게배웠죠예그래서언어적인측면에서는뭐크게문제가없어요예중국어하는거는뭐자신있는편이고그리고한국가서도계속이제대학교다니고 취업하고뭐회사다니고군대에서하고했지만이제어렸을때배운언어라서그렇게쉽게잊혀지지는않는것같아요한국에서이제그러한 8, 9년하고이제그러다가이제하고싶은게커피일찍일이라서이쪽에기회가있어서송도에와서커피를하게됐습니다
추호진의커피공장은중국서남지역의최대커피생두저장창고이며전세계각지에서온300톤의커피생두를저장할수있습니다
현재저희카페가이쪽이제진유区에있는공원에있는데저희가지하광장면적이한3000평이되고
이제 생도 보관 창고가 있고 로스팅 룸이 있고 포장 공간 그리고 바 스테이션이 있고 베이커리 주방이 있고 그다음에 브루잉 바도 따로 준비돼 있고. 네, 이제 새로 들어온 생도를 본관에서 가져가겠습니다. 하나에 60kg. 지금 8개 왔으니까. 네, 보통 한 달에 한 번씩 들어가고 있어요. 네, 오늘 들어온 생구는 콜롬비아, 브라질, 과테말라, 멕시코 여러 군데서 왔네요. 에티오피아에서 온 거 많이 왔습니다. 네, 지금 대략 한 3톤 정도 왔고.
커피 공장이 보유한 커피 생도는 1000여 개가 넘은 커피숍을 대상으로 생도 공급이 가능합니다. 누구나 이곳에서 커피 생도가 거기에서 내던 커피로 변화하는 과정을 살펴볼 수 있습니다.
저희는 지금 이제 로스팅을 진행하려고 하고 있고요. 오늘은 콜롬비아 원두로 로스팅을 할 예정입니다. 2kg 정도 로스팅을 하려고 해요. 네, 이제 생두를 투입했고 이제 로스팅을 시작할 예정입니다. 저희 로스터 하는 공간이 야외 유리로 돼 있어서 네, 이제 손님들이 오시면 직접 뭐 저희 로스팅하는 과정 다 확인할 수 있고 볼 수 있습니다. 우리가 공장형 카페를 만들어서 이제 단순히 이제 생두를 직접 로스팅해서 판매하는 정도가 아닌 좀 더 생두에 접근할 수 있게 지역적인 문제로 인해서 고객들과는 멀어지고 왜냐하면 고객들은 실제로 가서 볼 수가 없기 때문에 공장을 근데 우리는 어쨌든 시내에 위치해 있고 고객들과도 가깝게 접근할 수 있다는 장점을 갖고 있어서
你好
现在我们这边的豆子定制是这么一个情况您平时喜欢喝什么样的咖啡豆可以试一试就像我们有巴西埃塞俄比亚哥伦比亚和危地马拉
平常我喝这个喝的比较多
哦巴西的喝的比较多
现在 我想尝尝那个危地马拉这个
危地马拉这个是吧、
这个、我想尝尝这个
这些豆子根据您的需求就销售到您这边就是如果您下回可以就是把容器就是 找一个简单一点小一点的容器带过来这样更环保我们也不会产生垃圾
청도의사람들이문화의다양성을받아들이는데있어서는굉장히포용적이고굉장히용감하게받아들이고있다라고생각됩니다커피도다양한문화로받아들여서그와같이생활하는게크게거부감이없는그런도시라서여기서커피가잘되는것같습니다
커피공장이개업하지얼마안됐는데도불구하고커피팬들이시선을걸고빈자리가없을정도로바쁩니다하지만현재커피공장의운영상황은추호진이예상하는목표에비하면아직걸어가야한길이많습니다잉어백을제거하는방법은추호진이가장시급하게해결해야할난제입니다
现在 A 的量生产出来是比如说一千克对不对 B 的量生产出来是两千克
比例都知
是 A 加 B
对吧等于你不知道比例他们都知道比例啊他们给你比例不就行吗这个问题就很简单了呀
你要比例嘛
영업의문제는항상있죠왜냐면어쨌든소비자를끌어들이려면소비자들이좋아하는걸해야되고실제가게운영은굉장히쉽지않은일인것같아요어떻게하면더좋은곳을만들어서더고객들에게더좋은곳을제공할수있을까정말오랜시간동안이제이런것들에대해서고민했어요성도사람들의생활에녹여있었으면좋겠어요다양한행사뭐음악회가될수도있고패션쇼가될수도있고미술전시회가될수도있고여러가지행사들도이곳에서할수있다고생각해요편안하게이게커피마실때되면우리생각할수있는뭐그런곳이었으면좋겠어요
더많은고객을이끌고또한창도사람의일상에커피문화가더깊게스며들기위해 추호진은 커피 공장에서 커피 생두 로스팅 대회를 개최하기로 했습니다.
이번 로스팅 대회는 이제 스트롱홀드가 중국에서 꾸준히 주최하고 있는 이제 로스팅 대회인데요. 지금 선수들은 이제 로스팅을 직접 지나고 있고 일부 선수들은 이제 로스팅 끝난 후에 또 이제 최대한 자기들이 원하는 콩만 써서 더 좋은 이제 성적을 낼 수 있도록 노력하게. 나고 싶죠, 미시.
이제 터스다.
잘 싸면요. 이 기계는 저희가 로스팅 프로파일을 다 직관적으로 확인할 수 있어서 온도가 올라가는 거, 이제 내려가는 거 다 직접적으로 확인할 수 있고 저 안쪽에 로스팅되는 콩의 색깔 변화도 직접적으로 육안으로 확인이 가능하고 대회의 이제 감독은 사실 처음인데 기본적으로 상당히 재미있는 것 같아요. 여러분들의 열정도 느낄 수 있고 좋은 것 같습니다. 지금은 이제 엄청 많이 카페들이 생기고 다들 자기들의 문화를 가지고 또 재밌게 즐겨가면서 할 수 있는 큰 이제 커피 시장이 되었죠. 네. 저희들도 이제 기존의 음선에서 인수리가 되고 좀 더 크게 발전할 수 있는 기회가 되었고.
3년 전 여름 추호진의 첫 번째 커피숍 음선 커피 금문향에서 오픈했습니다. 추호진의 눈에 이곳은 자신의 청춘과 꿈을 담은 곳입니다.
이제 이쪽에 보이시는 곳이 저희의 음선 커피의 1호점입니다. 그 당시에 11월 달이었는데 이제 여기 이제 막 이제 은행나무가 막 이제 노랗게 되고 길거리 분위기도 되게 차분하고 전반적인 분위기가 되게 괜찮았어요. 你好
好久没来是不是 买点这个这好不好吃哦这边是药店有水果铺子这有金钟肉店卖肉的这边基本上都是菜市场啊吃啥好吃的我也没吃饭呢饭
我们吃水果吧，吃点葡萄。네가끔이제저쪽일끝나면좀와서한번씩둘러보고예그러고있습니다제가만들었던게많아서여기는예항상오면이제편안하죠여기는최근에는잘못오죠예힘드니까앞에저희가잘아는카페가하나더있는데요네같이가서한번구경해보시고저녁에는맥주도파니까뭐가끔가다맥주한잔씩하고합니다 네, 네여기입니다브로키라고해요
야
Hello.
Hi,
Hello. Hello.
好久不见
好久不见好久不见
喝点啥
随便随便啤酒啤酒啤酒
整一杯嘛
好吗啤酒啤酒啤酒
好的其实我们这个店 Corky 我还要给你解释一下它翻译过来是黑酒的意思
对吧
黑酒白天卖咖啡晚上卖酒
对啊黑酒就是咖啡啊这个我知道
현재청도에서개업한커피숍은8000개에이르고전국도시커피숍속의통계순위3위를차지하고있습니다청도에서는평균적으로하루에신균커피숍이한나씩생기고있습니다커피숍사장님들이자신의커피숍을멋스럽게꾸미므로서동시에동네의모습과분위기도점차변화하고있습니다커피숍은사람들이동네미시티탐방의이유로꼽을수있습니다
我觉得最有特色的一点就是在成都最明显的是社区店会多很多就是有这种定位或者以这种方式在经营的咖啡小店是很多很多的想要把咖啡带给你的一种惬意的生活方式再分享给别人
我们的
精品咖啡厅，
对，
是你不一定要开到那种繁华的，
对，
你要做小众一点的话，你真的就是开到那种大街小巷，等你慢慢把口碑做起来，就等顾客自己来找你了，就这么简单。只要你能交出一份满意的答卷，那就。
나는이런커피를만들고나는이런커피를만들고나는이런커피를만든다각자의다양성이있기때문에이게다같이할수있다고생각해요네왜냐하면다같이똑같은커피팔면이렇게많이열필요가없어요각자의다양성을충분히가지고이제운영을하는거고그렇기때문에이제다같이공존할수있는
周末愉快
周末周末愉快
周末愉快
周末愉快生意越来越好
周末愉快
OK
이게제가대학교때심리학이제수업을들으면서들은얘기인데이제어떤이제꿈이나이제이런미래에대해서생각을하고그거를기록을하고그거를매일매일보면사람이자동적으로어떤그런방향으로이제발전을하게된다고생각해요사실지금은이제그런생각도하죠고등학교때이런생각을했었는데어떻게어떻게하다보니까이렇게성공적으로그꿈을실현할수있었다근데아직은이제더잘해서더좋은방향으로이것을이끌어가고싶다예그렇게생각하고있습니다성도의시장이좀더발전하면서마찬가지로저희도거기서어느정도역할을하면서같이발전했으면좋겠다는생각을하고있습니다
Is Chengdu a city of food or a city of foodies? Eating is one of the most cohesive activities around the world. But nowhere is that truer than in Chengdu, China. Chengdu would no doubt be the only city where you can find with this much incredible food and this many crazy foodies. If you've been to any of the famous restaurants here, you've certainly heard the word bus many times.This is the most prominent personality of the people living here. And this is why Chengdu people seem to be able to tolerate everything about you. Whether you go for spicy or non-spicy hot pot, whether you are Chinese or a foreigner.
我把成都作为我中国的老家，我的很多本地的朋友已经认识了二十多年了。
It may be hard for you to imagine that a British girl swore to try all the delicacies of China within a year, but was still hanging around in Chengdu 3 years later. Actually, it was 3 years, and then another 3 years, and still a few more 3 years when Fu Xia finished yet another redefinition of Sichuan cuisine.Is Chengdu a city of food? Perhaps when the flavor of the Sichuan paper exploded on the tongue of this British girl, something inside her was changed forever.
川菜在国外越来越流行，基本上所有的美食家都知道川菜，都喜欢川菜。
Combining all kinds of Chinese and Western styles, Chengdu is a place with densely distributed global delicacies.It is a battle for any chef to secure a place in this city. In the eyes of Andrew Chum, who worked as a chef in Singapore for many years, dishes are not only for eating, but are also expressions of the chef's heart and aesthetics.
You are good?
Yeah.
Do you think this looks like Sichuan cuisine? No matter what it looks like, as long as the soul is still there. Chengdu people can have Sichuan cuisine presented in a million different ways.Here you will discover all kinds of possibilities about eating that cannot be found elsewhere. Is Chengdu a city of foodies? Perhaps when this French cuisine chef goes onto the bridge, eating becomes something more. This is one of the most rapidly developing cities in China. Yet hidden in the streets and alleys here,There remain countless precious gems of authentic and soulful food culture. This Canadian Jordan spends most of his time taking foodies who come from all over the world to hunt for and find the soul of Sichuan.
I know a great beef restaurant on Baojiaxiang, a great bulgogi on Wangpingjie, there's really good qiaoshou on Jixiangjie, tangyouguozi, you want to go to Tongrenlu. There's some great hot pot restaurants at Xi'anbeilu.
When you have meat dumplings in spicy sauce on Jixiang Street, sweet and spicy noodles on Wenshuyuan Street, crusty pancakes filled with bean jelly at Wenshuyuan Metro Entry, pickles and pepper at Grocery Market,
exactly what's happening.
At Marketplace Sichuan Cuisine at Wai Cao Jiaxiang, you will find that all the bustling scenes and enjoyable bites of food are the secret power that nourishes the personality of Chengdu people. Eating is the fastest and simplest way of understanding Chengdu. Here you can taste both traditional and modern flavors with a bowl of noodles, and experience both Oriental and Western styles in one dish. Every taste bud will find its perfect balance in the atmosphere of this city. Is Chengdu a city of foodies? Is Chengdu a city of food? We'll let you find out yourself.